Chapter 1. Units and Measurements. Introduction. Measurement of any physical quantity involves comparison with a certain basic arbitrarily chosen internationally accepted reference standard called unit. The result of the measurement of a physical quantity is expressed by a number or numerical measure accompanied by a unit. Although the number of physical quantities appears to be very large, we need only a limited number of units for expressing all the physical quantities, since they are interrelated with one another. The units for the fundamental or base quantities are called fundamental or base units. The units for all other physical quantities can be expressed as combinations of the base units. Such units obtained for the derived quantities are called derived units. A complete set of these units, both the base units and derived units, is known as the system of units. The international system of units. In earlier times, scientists of different countries were using different systems of units for measurement. Three such systems, the CGS, the FPS or British system, and the MKS system, were in use extensively till recently. The base units for length, mass and time in these systems were as follows. In CGS, centimeter, gram and second. In FPS, foot, pound and second. And in MKS, meter, kilogram and second respectively. The system of units which at present is internationally accepted for measurement is the Systeme Internationale des Unites, French for International System of Units, abbreviated as SI. The SI, with standard scheme of symbols, units and abbreviations developed by the Bureau Internationale des Poids et Measures or the International Bureau of Weights and Measures, BIPM, in 1971, were recently revised by the General Conference on Weights and Measures in November 2018. The scheme is now for international usage in scientific, technical, industrial and commercial work. Because SI units use decimal system, conversions within the system are quite simple and convenient. We shall follow the SI units in this book. In SI, there are 7 base units as given in table 1.1. Besides the 7 base units, there are 2 more units that are defined for A. Plane angle d theta as the ratio of length of arc ds to the radius r. And B, solid angle d omega, as the ratio of the intercepted area dA of the spherical surface described about the apex O, as the center, to the square of its radius r as shown in figure 1.1a and b respectively. The unit for plane angle is radian and the symbol rad, and the unit for solid angle is radian with the symbol sr. Both these are dimensionless quantities. Length meter m, mass kilogram kg, time second s, electric ampere capital A, thermodynamic temperature kelvin capital K, amount of substance mole mol, luminous intensity candela cd. Note that when mole is used, the elementary entities must be specified. These entities may be atoms, molecules, ions, electrons, other particles or specified groups of such particles. We employ units for some physical quantities that can be derived from the 7 base units, Appendix A6. Some derived units in terms of the SI base units are given in Appendix A6.1. Some SI derived units are given special names, and some derived SI units make the use of these units with special names and the 7 base units. These are given in Appendix 6.2, 6.3 for your ready reference. Other units retained for general use are given in Table 1.2. Common SI prefixes and symbols for multiples and submultiples are given in Appendix A2. General guidelines for using symbols for physical quantities, chemical elements and nuclides are given in Appendix A7, and those for SI units and some other units are given in Appendix A8 for your guidance and ready reference. significant figures. As discussed above, every measurement involves errors. Thus, the result of measurement should be reported in a way that indicates the precision of measurement. Normally, the reported result of measurement is a number that includes all digits in the number that are known reliably, plus the first digit that is uncertain. The reliable digits plus the first uncertain digit are known as significant digits or significant figures. If we say the period of oscillation of a single pendulum is 1.62 seconds, the digits 1 and 6 are reliable and certain, while the digit 2 is uncertain. Thus, the measured value has three significant figures. The length of an object reported after measurement to be 287.5 cm has four significant figures. The digits 287 are certain, while the digit 5 is uncertain. Clearly reporting the results of measurement that includes more digits than significant digits is superfluous and also misleading, since it would give a wrong idea about the precision of the measurement. The rules for determining the number of significant figures can be understood from the following examples. Significant figures indicate, as already mentioned, the precision of measurement, which depends on the least count of the measuring instrument. A choice of change of different units does not change the number of significant figures or figures in the measurement. This important remark makes most of the following observations clear. Number 1. For example, the length 2.308 cm has four significant figures, but in different units, the same value can be written as 0.02308 meter or 23.08 millimeter or 23080 mm. All these numbers have the same number of significant figures, digits 2, 3, 0 and 8, namely 4. This shows that the location of decimal point is of no consequence in determining the number of significant figures. The example given gives the following rules. All the non-zero digits are significant. All the zeros between two non-zero digits are significant, no matter where the decimal point is, if at all. If the number is less than 1, the zeros on the right of the decimal point but to the left of the first non-zero digits are not significant. In 0.002308, the underlined zeros are not significant. The terminal or trailing zeros in a number without a decimal point are not significant. Thus, 123 meter is equal to 12300 centimeter equals to 123000 millimeter has three significant figures, the trailing zeros being not significant. However, you can also see the next observation. Trailing zeros in a number with a decimal point are significant. The numbers 3.500 or 0.06900 have four significant figures each. Number 2. There can be some confusion regarding the trailing zeros. Suppose a length is reported to be 4.700 meters. It is evident that the zeros here are meant to convey the precision of measurement and are therefore significant. If this were not, it would be superfluous to write them explicitly. The reported measurement would have been simply 4.7 meter. Now suppose we change units, then 4.700 meter is equal to 470.0 centimeter equals to 4700 millimeter, which is equal to 0.004700 kilometer. Since the last number has trailing zeros in a number with no decimal, we would conclude erroneously from observation 1 that the number has two significant figures, while in fact it has four significant figures, and a mere change of units cannot change the number of significant figures. Number 3. To remove such ambiguities in determining the number of significant figures, the best way is to report every measurement in scientific notation in the power of 10. In this notation, every number is expressed as a into 10 to the power b, where a is a number between a and 1 and 10, and b is any positive or negative exponent or power of 10. In order to get an approximate idea of number, we may round off the number a to 1 for a is less than or equal to 5, and to 10 for a between 5 and less than or equal to 10. Then the number can be expressed approximately as 10 to the power b. in which the exponent or power b of 10 is called order of magnitude of the physical quantity when only an estimate is required. The quantity is of the order 10 to the power b. For example, the diameter of Earth 1.28 into 10 to the power 7 meter is of order of 10 to the power 7 meter with the order of magnitude 7. The diameter of hydrogen atom 1.06 into 10 to the power minus 10 meter is of the order 10 to the power minus 10 with the order of magnitude minus 10. Thus, the diameter of Earth is 17 orders of magnitude larger than the hydrogen atom. It is often customary to write the decimal after the first digit. Now, the confusion mentioned in A above disappears. The power of 10 is irrelevant to the determination of significant figures. However, all zeros appearing in the base number in the scientific notation are significant. Each number in this case has four significant figures. Thus, in the scientific notation, no confusion arises about the trailing zeros in the base number A. They are always significant. Number 4. The scientific notation is ideal for reporting measurement. But if this is not adopted, we use the rules adopted in the preceding example. For a number greater than 1, without any decimal, the trailing zeros are not significant. For a number with a decimal, trailing zeros are significant. Number 5. The digit 0 conventionally put on the left of a decimal for a number less than 1, like 0.1250, is never significant. However, the zeros at the end of such number are significant in the measurement. Multiplying or dividing factors which are neither rounded numbers nor numbers representing measured values are exact and have infinite number of significant digits. For example, in r is equal to d by 2 or s is equal to 2 pi r, the factors 2 is an exact number and it can be written as 2.0, 2.00 or 2.0000 as required. Similarly, in t is equal to small t by small n, n is an exact number. Rules for arithmetic operations with significant figures. The result of a calculation involving approximate measured values of quantities, that is, values with limited number of significant figures, must reflect the uncertainties in the original measured values. It cannot be more accurate than the original measured values themselves, on which the result is based. In general, the final result should not have more significant figures than the original data from which it was obtained. Thus, if mass of an object is measured to be, say, 4.237 grams, four significant figures, and its volume is measured to be 2.51 centimeter cube, then the density by mere arithmetic division is 1.688047808 gram per centimeter cube, up to 11 decimal places. It would be clearly absurd and irrelevant to record the calculated value of density to such a precision when the measurements on which the value is based have much less precision. The following rules for arithmetic operations with significant figures ensure that the final result of a calculation is shown with a precision that is consistent with the precision of the input measured values. Number 1. In multiplication or division, the final result should retain as many significant figures as are there in the original number with the least significant figures. Thus, in the example above, density should be reported to 3 significant figures. Density is equal to 1.69 gram per centimeter cube. Similarly, if the speed of light is given as 3.00 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, 3 significant figures, and 1 year is equal to 365.25 days, has 3.1557 into 10 to the power 7 seconds, 5 significant figures, the light year is 9.47 into 10 to the power 15 meter, 3 significant figures. Number 2. In addition or subtraction, the final result should retain as many decimal places as are there in the number with the least decimal places. For example, the sum of the numbers 436.32 grams, 227.2 grams and 0.301 grams by mere arithmetic addition is 663.821 grams, but the least precise measurement, 227.2 grams, is correct to only one decimal place. The final result should therefore be rounded off to 663.8 grams. Similarly, the difference in length can be expressed as 0.307 meter minus 0.304 meter is equal to 0.003 meter, which is equal to 3 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. Note that we should not use the rule 1 applicable for multiplication and division and write 664 gram as the result in the example of addition and 3.00 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter in the example of subtraction. They do not convey the precision of measurement properly. For addition and subtraction, the rule is in terms of decimal places. Rounding off the uncertain digits. The result of computation with approximate number which contain more than one uncertain digit should be rounded off. The rules for rounding off numbers to the appropriate significant figures are obvious in most cases. A number 2.746 rounded off to three significant figures is 2.75, while the number 1.743 should be 1.74. The rule by convention is that the preceding digit is raised by 1 if the insignificant digit to be dropped, the number underlined in this case, is more than 5 and is left unchanged if it is less than 5. But what if the number is 2.745? In which the insignificant digit is 5. Here the convention is that if preceding digit is even, the insignificant digit is simply dropped, and if it is odd, the preceding digit is raised by 1. The number 2.745 rounded off to three significant figures becomes 2.74. On the other hand, the number 2.735 rounded off to three significant becomes 2.74. Since the preceding digit is odd. In any involved or complex multi-step calculation, you should retain in intermediate steps one digit more than the significant digits and round off to proper significant figures at the end of calculation. Similarly, a number known to be within many significant figures, such as 1.997924.58 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second for the speed of light in vacuum, is rounded off to an approximate value 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, which is often employed in computations. Finally, remember that exact numbers that appear in formula like 2 pi in t is equal to 2 pi root L by g have a large infinite number of significant figures. The value of pi is equal to 3.1415926 ... is known to a large number of significant figures. You may take the values as 3.142 or 3.144 pi with limited number of significant figures as required in specific cases. Rules for determining the uncertainty in the results of arithmetic calculations. The rules for determining the uncertainty or error in the number or measured quantity in arithmetic operations can be understood from the following examples. 1. If the length and breadth of a thin rectangular sheet is measured using a meter scale as 16.2 cm and 10.1 cm respectively, there are three significant figures in each measurement. It means that the length L may be written as 16.2 plus minus 0.1 cm. Which is equal to 16.2 plus minus 0.6%. Similarly, the breadth B may be written as 10.1 plus minus 0.1 cm, which is equal to 10.1 plus minus 1%. The error of the product of two or more experimental values using the combination of errors rule will be LB is equal to 163.62 cm square plus minus 1.6%, which is equal to 163.62 plus minus 2.6 cm square. This leads us to quote the final result as area is equal to 164 plus minus 3 cm square. Here 3 cm square is the uncertainty or error in the estimation of area of a rectangular sheet. Number 2. If a set of experimental data is specified to n significant figures, a result obtained by combining the data will also be valid to n significant figures. However, if data are subtracted, the number of significant figures can be reduced. For example, 12.9 grams minus 7.06 grams, both specified to 3 significant figures, cannot properly be evaluated as 5.84 grams, but only as 5.8 grams, as uncertainties in subtraction or addition combine in a different fashion. Smallest number of decimal places rather than number of significant figures in any of the number added or subtracted. Number 3. The relative error of a value of number specified to significant figures depends not only on n but also on the number itself. For example, the accuracy in the measurement of mass 1.02 grams is plus minus 0.01 gram, whereas another measurement 9.89 gram is also accurate to plus minus 0.01 grams. The relative error in 1.02 gram is plus minus 0.01 divided by 1.02 grams into 100%, that is plus minus 1%. Similarly, the relative error in 9.89 grams is plus minus 0.01 divided by 9.89 into 100, which is equal to plus minus 0.1%. Finally, remember that intermediate results in a multi-step computation should be calculated to one more significant figure in every measurement than the number of digits in the least precise measurement. These should be justified by the data, then arithmetic operations may be carried out. Otherwise, rounding errors could build up, for example, the reciprocal of 9.58 calculated after rounding off to the same number of significant figures 3 as 0.104, but the reciprocal of 0.104 calculated to 3 significant figures is 9.62. However, if we had written 1 by 9.58 is equal to 0.1044 and then taken the reciprocal to 3 significant figures, we would have retrieved the original value of 9.58. This example justifies the idea to retain one more extra digit than the number of digits in the least precise measurement in intermediate steps of complex multi-step calculations in order to avoid additional errors in the process of rounding of numbers. Dimension of physical quantities. The nature of physical quantity is described by its dimensions. All the physical quantities represented by derived units can be expressed in terms of some combination of 7 fundamental or base units. We shall call these base quantities as the 7 dimensions of the physical world, which are denoted with square brackets. Thus, length has dimension L, mass M, time T, electric current A, thermodynamic temperature K, luminous intensity CD, and amount of substance MOL. The dimensions of a physical quantity are the powers or exponents to which the base quantities are raised to represent that quantity. Note that using the square brackets round a quantity means that we are dealing with the dimension of the quantity. In mechanics, all the physical quantities can be written in terms of the L, M, and T. For example, volume occupied by an object is expressed as a product of length, breadth, and height, or three lengths. Hence, dimension of volume is L cube. As the volume is independent of mass and time, it is said to possess zero dimension in mass, m to the power 0, and zero dimension in T, T to the power 0, and 3 dimensions in length. Similarly, force as the product of mass and acceleration can be expressed as mass into acceleration, which is length by time square. The dimensions of force are m, l, t to the power minus 2. Thus, force has one dimension of m, mass, one dimension of length, and minus 2 dimensions in time. The dimensions in all other base quantities are zero. Note that in this type of representation, the magnitude are not considered. It is the quality of the type of physical quantity that enters. Thus, a change in velocity, initial velocity, average velocity, final velocity, and speed are all equivalent in this context. Since all these quantities can be expressed as length by time, their dimensions are L t to the power minus 1. Dimensional formula and dimensional equations. expression which shows how and which the base quantities represent the dimensions of a physical quantity is called dimensional formula of the given physical quantity. For example, the dimensional formula of the volume is m to the power 0 l cubed d to the power 0, and that of speed and velocity is m to the power 0 l t to the power minus 1. Similarly, m to the power 0 l t to the power minus 2 is dimensional formula of acceleration, and m l to the power minus 3 t to the power 0 that of density. An equation obtained by equating a physical quantity with its dimensional formula is called dimensional equation of the physical quantity. Thus, the dimensional equations are the equations which represent the dimensions of a physical quantity in terms of base quantities. For example, dimensional equation of volume V, speed small v, force F and mass density rho may be expressed as V is equal to m to the power 0 L cubed t to the power 0. Small v is equal to m to the power 0 L t to the power minus 1. F is equal to ml t to the power minus 2. And rho is equal to m L to the power minus 3 t to the power 0. The dimensional equation can be obtained from the equation representing the relations between the physical quantities. The dimensional formula of a large number and wide variety of physical quantities derived from the equations representing the relationships among other physical quantities and expressed in terms of base quantities are given in Appendix 9 for your guidance and ready reference. 1.6. Dimensional analysis and its applications. The recognition of concepts of dimensions which guide the description of physical behavior is of basic importance, as only those physical quantities can be added or subtracted which have the same dimensions. A thorough understanding of dimensional analysis helps us in deducing certain relations among different physical quantities and checking the derivation accuracy and dimensional consistency or homogeneity of various mathematical expressions. When magnitudes of two or more physical quantities are multiplied, their units should be treated in the same manner as ordinary algebraic symbols. We can cancel identical units in the numerator and denominator. The same is true for dimensions of physical quantity. Similarly, physical quantities represented by symbols on both sides of a mathematical expression must have the same dimensions. Checking the dimensional consistency of equations. Magnitudes of physical quantities may be added together or subtracted from one another only if they have the same dimensions. In other words, we can add or subtract similar physical quantities. Thus, velocity cannot be added with force, or an electric current cannot be subtracted from thermodynamic temperature. This simple principle, called the principle of homogeneity of dimensions in an equation, is extremely useful in checking the correctness of an equation. If dimensions of all the terms are not same, the equation is wrong. Hence, if we derive an expression for the length or distance of an object regardless of the symbols appearing in the original mathematical relation, when all the individual dimensions are simplified, the remaining dimension must be that of length. Similarly, if we derive an equation of speed, the dimensions on the both sides of equation when simplified must be of length by time, or L t to the power minus 1. Dimensions are customarily used as a preliminary test of the consistency of an equation when there is some doubt about the correctness of the equation. However, the dimensional consistency does not guarantee correct equations. It is uncertain to the extent of dimensionless quantities of functions. The arguments of special functions such as trigonometric, logarithmic, and exponential functions must be dimensionless. A pure number ratio of similar physical quantities such as angle as the ratio length by length, refractive index as the ratio speed of light in vacuum by speed of light of medium, etc. has no dimensions. Now we can test the dimensional consistency of homogeneity of the equation x is equal to x naught plus v naught t plus half at square. For the distance x traveled by a particular body in time t, which starts from the position x naught with an initial velocity v naught at time equals to 0, has an uniform acceleration a along the direction of motion. The dimensions of each term may be written as x is equal to L, x naught equals to L. V naught t is equal to L t minus 1 into t, which is equal to L, and half a t square, which is equal to L t to the power minus 2 into t to the power 2, which is equal to L. As each term on the right hand side of this equation has the same dimension, namely of length, which is the same as the dimension of left hand side of the equation, hence this equation is dimensionally correct. It may be noted that a test of consistency of dimensions tells us no more or no less than a test of consistency of units, but has the advantage that we need not commit ourselves to a particular choice of units, and we need not worry about conversions among multiples and submultiples of the units. It may be borne in mind that if an equation fails this consistency test, it is proved wrong, but if it passes, it is not proved right. Thus, a dimensionally correct equation need not to be actually an exact correct equation, but a dimensionally wrong or incorrect or inconsistent equation must be wrong. Deducing relation among physical quantities. The method of dimensions can sometimes be used to deduce relation among the physical quantities. For this, we should know the dependence of physical quantity on one another. Upon three physical quantities on linearly independent variables and consider it as a product type of the dependence. Dimensional analysis is very useful in deducing relations among the independent physical quantities. However, dimensionless constants cannot be obtained by this method. The method of dimensions can only test the dimensional validity but not the exact relationship between physical quantities in any equation. It does not distinguish between the physical quantities having same dimensions. A number of exercises at the end of this chapter will help you develop skill in this dimensional analysis.